Switch is an automation tool for both OS X and Windows that can automate a whole host of repetitive tasks that are very often still done manually. Switch is built up in a modular way around a core engine and a number of modules that extend its functionality. This movie focuses exclusively on the metadata module. It is recommended that you've already watched the movies on Switch Core Engine and the Configurator module before this one. As the name suggests, the purpose of the metadata module is to add support for using and creating metadata in Switch. Metadata is data, or information about the data, and this can be of two kinds. It can be information about the data itself. How was the photograph taken? What application generated the file? To what production order does the file belong? And so on. But it can also be information about how the data should be processed, on what paper should it be printed, to what factory does the file have to be sent after processing, what is the intended trim size, which is not necessarily the same as the trim size of the data, and so on. The metadata can also be available in two different forms. It can be part of the data itself, or it can be in a separate file, usually XML. Examples of metadata that resides inside the file itself include the XMP part of certain file types like PDF, Photoshop, and InDesign, for example. When the metadata is supplied in a separate file, it is almost always in the form of an XML file. One comes across JDF, or Job Definition Format files, as well on a regular basis, but these are also just XML files. Let us first concentrate on using metadata. The two main areas in Switch where the metadata of a job is being used is in conditions with variables and in text with variables. In the movie on Switch Core Engine, you have already seen how Switch can route jobs along different paths in an intelligent and flexible way, but with the addition of the metadata module, this intelligence and flexibility are increased significantly. You can now draw on both the internal and external metadata and use any piece of information that is present in it. Here is an example with a condition. The metadata says whether the job should be processed as a black and white file or as a color file, so we can use that to route the job to the correct pit stop server instance. And here is an example with a single line text. The mail address of the person who should be informed in the case of a problem is taken from the metadata to make this property of the mail send element truly variable. In combination with the configurator module, the metadata module brings all that information within the reach of all third-party applications that integrate with Switch. The third-party application may not have support for dealing with XML files directly, but Switch makes it possible anyhow. Let us now look at creating metadata. From the previous examples, it will be clear how the presence of metadata can lift the automation of a flow to a higher level. But what if your business system is not capable of providing it? In a submit point, you can define any number and type of information fields that a Switch client user will be requested to fill in when submitting a file into the flow. Here we see the process of submitting a file. I provide all the requested information up front, touching the file only once. Switch stores the information in an XML format and attaches it automatically to the job. It is therefore available throughout the flow for making the routing decisions and filling in the correct values for element or configurator properties. It is worth noting that connectors made with one of the Connect products can also link into a Switch submit point. In that way, you can delegate the process, or at least a part of it, to the person who is submitting jobs to you. Watch the movies on the Connect products for more information. Some configurators will also attach metadata to a job. Pitstop Server, for example, can attach an XML report to the job. When a job has metadata attached to it, regardless through what method it got there, It can be exported in order to be used by another system, then switch. And should that other system expect a specific XML structure, you can transform the XML available to switch into another structure using the XSLT transform element. As you can see, the metadata module further increases the power of switch to help you achieve an even higher level of automation. Be sure to watch the videos on additional modules as well to see how these can further expand the power of switch.